Hey, what's up guys? A few weeks ago, I uploaded a video about how to sign in when sign in option is disabled on your Windows PC. This video is still helping a lot of people there. I will put a link into the description for that video too. In that video, some viewers asked in comments that forgot PIN or reset PIN option is not showing up or disabled for them. So stay tuned. In this video, I will show you four possible solutions to solve most Windows sign in problems. My name is Mazhar, and at Right Solutions, I create tutorial for all you DIY people. If you're new to my channel, please don't forget to subscribe and press the bell icon to get the notification for my next video. Now, without any further ado, let's get to the PC and see these four possible solutions. So let's look into the solution number one here. But before you do anything, just come on your keyboard here and press and hold down the left shift key and keep it down. And now go on to the right side here to the power button. And just click it, and now click restart. And now this another option had come, so just restart anyway. So now don't leave your key still, keep it pressed, and just let this system restart. Actually, just wait for it till the blue screen comes up. So please wait a little more, and just a few more seconds. And now you can release your shift key, and now here our choices we can say is continue to Windows 11 or maybe troubleshoot. So click on troubleshoot because we are just going to troubleshoot this one here. So now you got two more options. So just click on the advanced option here. And here you got a variety of tools to choose from. But let's select the first one, startup repair, and just wait for it until it finishes. And if your system has any problems, it will repair it. But mine, because I just had freshly installed, so it said it could not repair. So just click on advanced options here and go back to this menu again for troubleshoot. And now click again advanced options here. And now this time we will select startup settings. So this menu gives you a variety of options and you can choose it from. So just click on restart. And now the next page, it will show you what you can do with this here. So there are a lot of options from 1 to 9. You can just read it if you want. But we are going to select safe mode. So just click 4 or F4 to just start this menu. Kick this menu in. And now you just wait here till this menu works for you. So here on the login page, just key in your PIN, which you already know that it was working. So just you can say that it is already starting your PC. So you can see this safe mode is on. So once your safe mode is on, that means your PC will restart properly. So just click on the Windows icon button and just restart your system and it should be good. Generally, it is the last good known startup file. So just restart and it most probably it should bring you back to the regular operating Windows. Just wait for a while. It is going to finish it soon. This processing could take longer, depends on your system. I will just fast forward it to the time when it is getting logged in. Okay, so here you can see that your wallpaper here. So just click on your keyboard and key in the PIN, which you already know that it's supposed to be working now. And here we are, and you can see that we are already in our system here. So hopefully your problem is solved. If not, so just continue to the solution number two. From solution one, you already know how to come to this screen. So let's start from here. So click on troubleshoot. And now select advanced options again. And we have plenty of options on this page here. We already had used the first two. And we're not going to use command prompt for this video. And the next two command prompt is system image recovery. So if you have already made the system image recovery, we can use this, but we're not going to use this. So what are we going to use? We will use the system restore for this video now for the solution number two. So click on system restore. And now on this page, click on next again. And now this is the page where you will have all the system restore points created by your computer. I have freshly installed Windows, so I just created this one restore point for the sake of this video. But you might will have more than one. You possibly have 3, 4, 5, and they are in order and they're named by the date and time. So you can select the last one. I prefer second last. So just select the restore point of your choice, last one or second last, which is your preference. But before you press next button, there is an option for you to just scan for the affected program. So if you just click on it, it will print you the list of the program which are going to affect from this restore point. So normally mine has no program affected, I just fresh installed. So just go ahead and press next now. And on this next page here, just click finished. And now you can see there's a warning for you. Once it started, system restore cannot be interrupted. Do you want to continue? So just click on yes again. And now it will take a little while. So I'll just fast forward the system. System restore completed successfully. The system has been restored to this date and this time, and your documents have not been affected. So click restart button to restart the computer. So just click on restart here, and just wait until your system comes back online. So here we are, your system is powered on. So just key in the PIN, and now you can see most probably it will let you get into your system. So just wait a few more seconds here. And here we are. So you can just see that it's also giving you the information about the system restore point, the date and the time, and that's it. So that means your system is already functioning. And if this did not help, just go to the solution number 3. So for solution 3, come back to the same page here and click on troubleshoot. And now let's select uninstall updates. And on this next page here, you will see that two updates are here. The one is the latest quality update. The other one is the latest feature updates. So mostly the feature updates are the one which actually causing some troubles. So, but you have to try both of it. So let's try first the uninstall latest feature updates. So here on this page, it is also giving you the information that uninstalling this update might well help if you're having any problem. So just click on uninstall updates. It did not find any update to uninstall, so that's why it's saying we run into a problem and won't be able to uninstall. So just close this and go back again to the troubleshoot. And again, just click on advanced options. And then again, click on uninstall updates. And now this time click on uninstall latest quality updates, and just click on uninstall quality updates again. And you can see that it does not find any updates because I just freshly installed. But if your system had trouble with any updates, so it will definitely uninstall it, and your system will come back online out of that trouble again. So if you think your problem is solved, so it's good. If not, so then continue to the solution number 4. So for solution 4, come back again to the same menu and click on troubleshoot. And here, this time we will use reset this PC. So just click on this reset PC, and you will find here two options. So the option 1 is remove everything, and the option 2 is to keep my files. I would suggest to use this cautiously. I mean, this is the last resort. If you think nothing is working for you, so then you can use this. So if you are ready to use it, so just click on keep my files. And on this next page here, you have two options here. So one is that the image of this installation can be downloaded from cloud. And be careful if you're having a metered connection. So it might will cost you, it's about 4 to 6 GB. So I would select local install. So just click on this option here. Okay, it's getting ready. And now you can see it is also giving you some information. So first thing, making sure that are you ready to reset, because it is cannot be undone again. So they are also giving you a question that you have to keep your device plugged in, and also resetting will change your settings back to their defaults, and also keep personal files, reinstall Windows from the device, and remove all the apps and program which did not come with this PC. So make sure that you want this, and if you want it, click on reset. And wait for the installation to be finished. It will take quite a long time. It again depends on the system and the version of Windows. I will fast forward this to the point when it will come to the login window. Your system will start a couple of times, and maybe your window will go blank for a while. So here we are. Now you can see that the wallpaper had come on. So just key in your PIN here. And it will take a little while because it's almost a fresh install, so it will just take a while to get login. And here we are. You can just see that you are already in inside your Windows. So if you can see here on this desktop, there is also a file which has given the list of all the affected programs. Mine, there is no program. So if you have any program which is affected, it will be listed here. So you can just have a look on it, and maybe you can reinstall. So that's it for this video. If you think this video added some value to you, so please give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. And I will see you with this next video. You have a great day.